Hello, it's Mug in Panic and welcome to the video where I will be rigging and animating Green Goblin drawn by RC McFly. Don't forget to comment, like and subscribe. Let's go! Alright, so everything started with splitting one layer. As you can see, I just have from RC McFly one drawing which I kind of cleaned up from the white that surrounds the character, and from that point I was able to start splitting it into separate layers. Because the whole animation is based on what's happening with the hoverboard, I started with it. So in order to make everything splitting correctly, I had to split every single part on every single each layer, and I had to draw what's behind. So in order to have a little bit of animation here and there, I need to have something that wasn't at this drawing at all. So as you can see, I'm trying to match with those circles where will be the joints for all of my things, and when I'm splitting the layers, I kind of starting to make that little hierarchy, as you can say. I added curve deformer to this hat thing so it can have a little overlap. And obviously here I had to draw a little thing that wasn't there because the head was covering it, and it's the it's pretty visible part, and it's cool to have it there. Then obviously more and more layers. Here is the pelvis, which caused some problems later, but I will talk about it when I will animate it. I had to change a little how the pelvis looked like, just a little slight change to make it work better in actual animation. Those circles, I put the pivot points inside of them in the very center, so I was able to have that rotational point, the joint, in the center of the circle, and with those circles I was just simulating the joints and all the connections that I would want to have without having any troubles later in animation. Of course, simulating this I guess drawing on paper or in some kind of software that allows you to create raster drawings, I had to simulate these raster drawings, so all my drawovers here and fixes are obviously rasterized drawing. So I not only had to draw the parts that I was missing, but because it was a raster drawing and I just had the picture, I had to kind of clean up some pixelations here and there where I wasn't happy so much about it. You saw a second ago where I colorized just a little of that dark space behind the arm, and I did that because I didn't need it more in order to make this animation. Here, my idea was to throw that smoke bomb up, so I had to split everything here to make it work correctly. So in order to make it done, I had to obviously draw that smoke bomb and simulate this raster drawing, which was pretty fun to do. I always like to do things like this. and obviously that hand that I will later add more poses when I will be doing some animation on this hand. And with that being said, let's move into rigging. So once I have everything done, I had to simply check if all my pegs and pivot points was on the position and if I had everything covered perfectly. So my main thing was to have the board and the pelvis, my two main things. And everything was connected to the pelvis, as you can see, pelvis, torso, neck, head, that kind of hierarchy. Just a simple, easy one, and two pegs, that one will contain movement and the second one will contain scale. And a little more separation here with composites. I was able to just clean up a little, which looked a little better in this configuration. Okay, so now let's go to the two-point constraint that I attached to the leg to merge joints from the hoverboard and the pelvis. There is a little thing here, as you can see, on the pelvis that I will fix later. I just checked if it will work out, and it will. So with two-point constraint and the hoverboard, I was able to achieve that kind of nice, super cool motion. I noticed that I missed a little separation here on the hand, so I really had to do it. Now, let's jump into animation part. In order to make this animation not super flat, I wanted to have it a way more depth of it. So as you can see, I kind of sketch how the motion looked like. If you saw my video about pegs and five things about pegs, I talked about locked in time keyframes. So in this configuration here, I unlocked all the keyframes, and once I was kind of happy with the result, I simply put everything on once and just manually fix it, because it's pretty unnatural movement and it's hard to simulate it with the just animation. Just let your computer do this. It's almost impossible in my opinion. And this entire animation was just try and fix. As you can see, I'm fixing every single detail all along this animation, and you will see it over and over. Once I was happy with the motion, I was able to add a little rotation, so I added additional peg because I was animation position on the drawing layer itself. Then I added a peg where I added this rotation. I of course started with this board because I knew it will be the main part of my animation and it will tell why and how the character is moving. I rescaled a little everything when the board is on the back to give a little more depth, and to make that cool nice parallax thing, I moved this head and the tail. And I also separated head and tail and move it to the peg on the top, so I could add additional skew to the board. Then I just checked how it looks like straight from this point, and I have to say I was happy about it. I just noticed I did a little mistake, so it had to be connected to the drawing layer instead of a peg, and I was able to start animating the pelvis. I can't say enough how many tries I did to animate this pelvis. It was so hard motion to achieve. I cut a lot from this video. It's kind of cool motion, and the breakthrough moment for me was when I did that additional peg and that additional pump for the bo here, for the hoverboard, which gave it a little more speed, and there I knew what I wanted to do. And it kind of looks like I steer this hoverboard with the body itself, and it was really, really cool. Here, I wanted the character to look at one point, so I had the perspective and I drew those lines to make this character look in that point, and then I was just fixing it a little. As you can see, I wanted to talk about it. I'm using function view in order to smooth out and check if I did any mistakes by adding rotational points to this animation. And I really, really encourage you to use that function view. I will make a video about it for sure, because it is a really, really nice tool. If you look at the 3D character animators, 3D animators, they can move around without this tool, and this tool is very important. I haven't seen casual 2D animators using this tool, and oh my god, they're losing a lot, leaving a lot behind. Okay, so this, oh my god, this curve deformer here was so tricky. I didn't want it to be so like fluffy and that type of stuff, and I realized that it's pretty hard to achieve anything with this motion. From now I see that I just instead of following this movement, I could just simulate the wind going through the character, and that would be much easier to achieve and will be probably more natural. But I'm happy with the result, what I achieved right now. Then it was just that arm that was kind of waving. As you can see, I'm always checking everything in my function view, and once I was happy with the arm, I moved into the hand with a little help of onion skinning at this point, and trying over and over and over if everything works correctly. And once I was happy with the result, I was able to move to the second arm. This arm was tricky because I had to throw the ball in the air, smoke bomb in the air, and again, just trying and trying, and how it will looks like. I wanted to record a reference for this, and I tried for a couple days, but I wasn't happy with anything that I recorded. Would be perfect to have that balance board. You can see them in trampoline parks, for example, but when I get there, it wasn't there for some reason, so I couldn't record my reference in a proper situation. So I just had to try. Without those pegs, with the movement of the character, I was able to just check everything without that movement distraction. So that was a cool trick to animate this board, not on the board layer, but on the very top peg. Okay, so there is a throwing part, a little bit of overlap, checking everything in function view, erasing some keyframes that are not important, and just messing around and checking if everything works correctly. Once I was happy with the motion, I was able to sketch additional keyframes for the arm to open it actually and catch the ball and fix that thumb, which was just a triangle in the air detached out of everything. So I drew this hand with the thumb, and then I was able to add a couple more in-betweens when the hand is leaving the smoke bomb, so smaller triangle, and then the hand with the thumb, and then one more keyframe where the hand is open, as you can see. It's cool because you can in Toon Boom draw behind on raster drawings. I love that. So when I'm filling with white, I'm drawing behind, so that's why I'm not messing around with my outline. I decided to make one more in between, just to have a little smoother motion in the catching ball animation. Okay, just a little additional fixes, and that was pretty much it for the hand. For the entire animation, I have to say, I'm very happy with how it turns out. As you can see, little cool motion. I decided to add effects and just a little bit of kind of smoky, flamey thing at the bottom. To stay consistent with the style, I had to do it on raster drawings, but I hate sketching on raster drawings, so I sketched it with vectors, and once I did that on the overlay layer, I just simply sketch it on the line layer. What's cool in Toon Boom is I can actually have on the line layer just rasterized drawings, and on the overlay layer my vector drawings, and it's pretty cool. And yeah, just the results here. I hope you enjoyed it, and well, have a wonderful day. Cheers.